How to Crochet an Easy Beginner Motif Cowl. This project features 4 balls of Be So Tender yarn. Download the free pattern at my website. The link to both the yarn and the pattern are in the video description.
We're going to be using a size J crochet hook today, which is also considered a 6mm, and I'm going to be keeping my yarn needle and scissors handy because for this project, I do think that there is some satisfaction in weaving in the ends as we go. We're going to start with the first round of the first motif, and at this point, you can choose any of the 4 colors to begin. We're going to tie the yarn onto our crochet hook, and you may do this in any way that you prefer. Some people prefer a slip knot, some people prefer a solid knot. Whichever works best for you is totally fine. And we're going to start with a chain 5. And then we're going to slip stitch into the 5th chain from our hook. We don't count the loop on our crochet hook, that's our working loop. So we're going to count back 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and slip stitch into that 5th chain from the hook. We now have a chain 5 ring, and that's where we're going to be placing all of our stitches in round 1. Chain 3, this counts as our first double crochet, and we're going to work a double crochet into the ring. Yarn over your hook, insert your hook in the ring, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. That's 1 double crochet. So the chain 3 counted as our first double crochet, and this counts as our second double crochet. We're going to do a 3rd one in the ring. Okay, so that counts as 3 double crochets now. Chain 3. And we're going to work 3 more double crochets in the same ring. Chain 3. And work 3 more double crochets in the same ring. You notice how I'm carrying my starting tail around with the chain 5 ring? That way I'm eating over, not eating, sometimes I call it eating, we're working over it with the ring so that we are already weaving this end in as we go. Okay, now we have 3 sets of 3 double crochet, chain 3. And we're going to work our 4th and final set of 3 double crochets in the ring. Chain 3. And we're going to slip stitch to the first double crochet at the beginning of the round to join. Our first double crochet was actually a chain 3. So you want to count up to the 3rd or the top chain of that chain 3, and we're going to slip stitch into the top of it, just like we would if it were a regular double crochet. This is what the end of round 1 should look like. We change color at the end of every round, so we're going to cut our yarn and fasten off. Now I know it's very tempting to leave all your ends until the end, but I do think that it is a better idea to weave them in as we go, because you'll not only have that task will be, you know, diluted throughout the project so it doesn't seem so daunting, doesn't take so long, and also your project will look prettier as you're going as well, which is a reward in itself. So first I'm going to weave in my ends, and you want to just kind of weave it back and forth into the knot structure of the stitches. And I'm going to go in one direction, then back in another direction. It's really important that you switch your direction when you're weaving in ends, because that way it's harder for the end to naturally come back out on its own. And then anytime you can get it into a cluster of stitches like this, this is very secure. And if you can pick up in any of the threads of that starting chain inside that cluster of stitches, that's also very secure. So we're going to go in one direction and then go back through in another direction. Now you want to make sure you don't pick up this, go with, back in from the same place you came out, otherwise it will undo your work. So I skip the first piece of yarn and go back in the other direction after that. And that is now a very secure woven in end. And we'll cut these. Okay, so now we have round one done. We're ready to begin round two of our first motif. So we're going to tie our yarn back onto our crochet hook. And slip stitch to join in any one of the chain three spaces. Chain three, which counts as a double crochet. I'm going to wrap my tail underneath so that I'm working it in as I crochet into this chain three space. So I'm holding it with the chain three space. We're going to work a double crochet in that same space. And another double crochet. Chain three. Three more double crochets in the same space. Okay, so in each of the chain three spaces, we're going to work three double crochets, chain three, three double crochets. It's just this first one where the first double crochet is actually a chain three that counts as a double. So for the rest of the round, we're going to skip the next three stitches and work three doubles, chain three, three doubles in the next chain three space. We're going to skip the next three stitches and do the same thing in the next chain three space. Three doubles, chain three, three doubles. Skip the next three stitches and work in the next chain three space. We're going to work three doubles, chain three, three doubles. And we're going to slip stitch to join in the top of the chain three at the beginning of the round. And that's what the second round and finished motif looks like when it's not being joined to any other motifs. With this next motif, I'm going to show you how to create this second round and join it to a second motif on a one-sided join. So we're going to start by tying our yarn onto our crochet hook. And slip stitch to join in any of the chain three spaces. Chain three, which counts as a double crochet in the ring, double crochet again in the ring, chain three, three more double crochets in the same ring. Okay, now in this corner and this corner, I'm going to join it to this motif in this corner and this corner. So we're going to start by skipping the next three stitches, double and work three double crochets in the next chain three space. Okay. Okay, now we would normally be doing chain three and three more doubles in that space. And we're going to replace our chain three with a chain one, slip stitch, chain one, and then continue on in our corner. So chain one, slip stitch into the chain three space, the center chain of that chain three space on the adjacent motif, chain one, and then coming back in our working motif, working three more double crochets in that same chain three space. And I'm going to set this down now so you can see what we did. Okay, so move my crochet hook too. Okay, so in our first corner, we did three doubles, chain three, three doubles. In our second corner, because we were joining it to another motif, we did three doubles, chain one, slip stitch, chain one, and three doubles in the corner. So now that chain three space is replicated with a chain one, slip stitch, chain one. It ends up being the same size, so it's the same shaped corner, but now it's joined to the other motif without having to use any sewing or any other techniques. We're just doing it as we go, which is a brilliant way to join motifs. We're now going to slip stitch into the space between the two corners on the adjacent motif. We didn't do a stitch here, but we're going to slip stitch to join it in the side. So I'm going to pick up my work again and insert my crochet hook into that space between this set of three double crochets and this set, just in that big space. We're going to grab my yarn in the right way. We're going to insert our crochet hook into that big space and just pull the yarn all the way through for a slip stitch. And I'll set this down again so you can see. So now we've joined in this side in two places. Now we're ready to begin our next corner on our working motif, and we're going to do it the same way we did that first corner. So I'm going to pick up my yarn and get started. We're going to start with three double crochets in that next chain three space. Okay, and now instead of a chain three, we're going to chain one, slip stitch into the center of the three chains in the adjacent motif, turn back, chain one. So we did chain one, slip stitch, chain one, and now we'll work three more double crochets in that same chain three space. And I'll set it down again so you can see where we're at. Okay, so we joined in this corner, we joined in this side, and we joined in this corner. So now to finish up this motif, we'll do our last corner with three doubles, chain three, three doubles, because it doesn't need to join to anything else. So we're now going to skip our three double crochets and in the next chain three space work three doubles. Chain three, three doubles, and slip stitch to the top of the chain three at the beginning of the round to join. Fasten off. And now we have two motifs completed and joined as we go. So we did this motif first, then we came and did this motif, and as we came around, we joined it in the corners and on the side to the adjacent motif. And this is what, in the crochet world of patterns, this is what we would call a one-sided join. In the further along in the video, I'm going to show you how to do a two-sided join as well. But for this portion, this is called a one-sided join because each of these squares has four sides, but we only joined on one side. Okay, we're going to do another motif, one-sided join. So slip stitch to any chain three space to get started. Work three double crochet, chain three, three double crochet in the first chain three space. Okay, and we're going to join in this corner to this motif, which means we're going to be joining in that same spot that the two of them were joined in before. So we're going to start with three doubles. And now we're going to chain one, slip stitch into that same chain where these two were joined. Remember how I said that in the corners we join into the center chain of the chain three space instead of just in the chain three space? It was so that when we come back and work additional ones in there, we get a really clean join. So you want to pay attention to which one was joined into which one. The seafoam green one was done first, and the cloud or cream colored one was slip stitched into that one. So we want to try to get to the original. So we're going to insert our crochet hook there and slip stitch, chain one. So we did a chain one, slip stitch, chain one, come back and work three more doubles in that same chain three space on our working motif. Okay, we're now going to slip stitch into the space between the two sets of three double crochets on the adjacent motif so that we're joining in the side. Come back to our working motif and work three double crochets in the next chain three space. Chain one, slip stitch into the center chain of the chain three space on the adjacent motif, chain one, and then come back and finish that corner with three more doubles in the same chain three space. Skip the next three doubles, and in the last chain three space, work three doubles, chain three, three doubles. Skip the last three double crochets and slip stitch into the top of the chain three at the beginning of the round to join and fasten off. Now you'll see we've done another one-sided join, but we've done it a little bit differently in the respect that we joined into a corner which was already joined into. So now we're creating a really beautiful tight corner where they're all being joined into the same chain, which as far as I'm concerned, I think it's the prettiest way to join in corners. On the side, it doesn't matter as much. You can join right into the big holes because they're only joined into one time. But anytime you're joining more than once, I think it looks absolutely gorgeous to make sure they join all in the same chain, because it's just a nice tight join and it's just visually pleasing to the eye, in my opinion. So now this is what the end of our third motif looks like. And we've joined on one side for three motifs. In the next section, I'm going to show you how to create a motif here and join it with a two-sided join. Okay, we're ready to begin our fourth and final motif with a two-sided join. We've already completed the first round, and now we're going to slip stitch into our first corner, chain three, and double crochet in the same chain three space, and double crochet again in the same chain three space. And in this first corner, we're going to start joining. So we're going to chain one, and we're going to slip stitch into the center of the chain three in this corner here. Slip stitch, then chain one, and then coming back into our working motif, work three more double crochets in that same corner. We're now going to slip stitch into the side on this motif in that big open space between this set of three double crochets and this set. So just slip stitch right into that big space. And then working back in our working motif, we're going to work, actually, let me set this down so you can see what I just did. It gets a little cumbersome picking it up, so it's not easy to see on camera. So I'll just show you what I did. I joined in this corner, three double crochets, chain one, slip stitch, chain one, three doubles, and then I slip stitched to the side of the adjacent motif in that big open space. And now I'm ready to begin my next corner on my working motif. and we're going to be joining in the center right here where those other three motifs are already joined together. So we're going to pick up our work, and now in our working motifs next corner, work three doubles. Chain one, then we're going to slip stitch into that same chain that all three motifs were already joined into. Chain one, so that chain one slip stitch chain one counts as our chain three space. Work three more doubles in the same chain three space in our working motif. Set it down so you can see where we're at. Okay, so we have one side adjoined. We're now coming along here, and we're going to slip stitch to join in the side of this motif, just in that open space between the two corners. Okay, so that's joined. Now we're ready to work this corner, and we're going to join it to this corner. So we're going to start on our working motif with three double crochets in the next chain three space. Chain one, slip stitch into the center chain of the chain three space on our adjacent motif, chain one, and back in our working motif, work three more doubles in that same chain three space. And set our work down again. Okay, we're joined on two sides, and now we just need to finish up our round. So now we're going to come around, and in our last chain three space, work three doubles, chain three, three doubles. And slip stitch to the first stitch at the beginning of the round to join, which is the top of the chain three. And now we have a two-sided join. So we started this motif here. Well, let's see, where'd we start? We started here. We joined in this corner, in this side, in this corner, in this side, in this corner, and then came around and finished it up. And before we finish, I really want to just show you again how beautiful that corner looks when they're all joined together in the same chain. Isn't that beautiful? It's definitely worth the extra effort to work into the chain instead of the space. Okay, so for this wrap, what I did was rows of four, and I just did that on and on and on, but I chose two color sequences for every other row. So we had the cloud in the center and blush on the outside, mushroom in the center, and seafoam on the outside for this whole row. Then the whole next row was seafoam on the inside, blush on the inside, seafoam on the inside, blush on the inside, and this was the, so it's the opposite, it's the same two colors. So notice cloud and blush are always together, and seafoam and mushroom are always together. But in this row of motifs, we put cloud and mushroom in the centers, and then in this row of motifs, I did seafoam and blush in the centers. And then this is the pattern that I repeat throughout the entire project. I find that making a pattern out of the color sequences actually is a design in itself and is a pattern in itself. You could do this more randomly. I mean, you could do this in any number of ways. You could do this all in one color. You could do this where the outside rounds are all one color and it's different colors in the center. You could do the centers all in one color and do the outside rounds in different colors. I mean, or you could just randomly do all different colors throughout as a stash buster. There's all different ways that you can do color sequencing, but I found that changing colors minimally, so we have four colors, but we have eight sequences, so our pattern is this eight square repeat, and you see that those eight squares are what I repeated throughout the entire wrap. And you can see it really does maintain a specific pattern that way. I absolutely love it. Now should you want to make this into a cowl, there's a couple of ways that we can join this short side to make it into a gigantic cowl. I've already folded the whole thing in half, and you could either go in with a yarn needle and a long piece of yarn, and you could sew right up this whole edge, sewing this side to this side as we go. Or we could join it with motifs. Now, the way you would join motifs now is that you would be joining them in that, doing that last round, you're going to join one sided join here and then join one sided here. So it's two sided join, working in all four corners, but working on joining one side at a time on two opposite sides of the motif. And then on the next motif and every one going forward, it would be then be a three-sided join. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, if this seems too advanced for you, by all means, go in and sew up here or add a couple of buttons. There are lots of easy ways to do this as well, but I thought, what the heck, let's do it the hard way just in case you're curious and want to see how it's done. So I've started this motif, started the corner. And we're now ready to join to our first corner. So I've got my first three doubles done, chain one, and join in the first corner. Okay, we're now going to work in our next chain three space on our working motif. Chain one, and then now working in a, oops, I forgot to join in the side. Hold on, let me back that up. We did our first corner, finished up with our three doubles. We're now going to slip stitch into the side of that same adjacent motif. And now working our next corner, work three doubles. Chain one, join in the same join of the next corner with a slip stitch, chain one, come back in our working motif and work three more doubles in the same chain three space. And you'll see now that we have one side joined. Now we're going to join these two corners on this motif here. So now coming along on our working motif, three doubles in the next chain three space. Chain one, slip stitch into the next corner, chain, center corner on the next corner of the adjacent motif, chain one, three doubles in the same chain three space in our working motif. And then slip stitch into the side hole on the adjacent motif. And then now work our last corner on our working motif with three doubles. Chain one, slip stitch into the center chain of the corner on the adjacent motif, chain one. We're going to finish up with three doubles in our same chain three space on the working motif. And slip stitch to join in the top of the chain three at the beginning of the round and fasten off. So now we have our first motif joined, and it's a two-sided join, but where we're joining on this side and this side, opposite sides of the motif. And funny enough that we actually use all four corners for joining on this one. In the next section, I'm going to show you how to join a three-sided join. Okay, I turned this around so that it's in the right positioning now for working our next motif. So this is the one that we just did. It's just turned around now. And now we're going to be joining three-sided in this space. I've started my motif already, and I've done the first three double crochets, or the chain three and two doubles to start my first corner. And we're going to chain one, and we're going to start by joining here. We're going to be working counterclockwise. We're starting in this corner here, and then we're going to slip stitch. chain one, and then back on our working motif, work three double crochets. Okay, we're now going to slip stitch into that space in the side of the adjacent motif. Okay, I'll set it back down so you can see we've joined in the corner and in the side. We're now ready to begin our next corner on our working motif, and we're going to join it to this corner here on the adjacents. So we'll start with three doubles. Chain one, and now into that corner here where the other motifs are joined, we're going to join in that same chain right in the corner with a slip stitch, chain one. Working back in our working motif, we're going to work three more doubles in that same corner. Okay, we'll set it down so you can see where we're at. We've joined in this corner on this side, in this corner. So now we are ready to join in this side. With a slip stitch. And now we're ready to work in the next corner on our working motif. We'll start it with three doubles. Chain one. Slip stitch into the same center chain in the corner of these motifs. Chain one, three more doubles in our same corner on our working motif. Set it down so you can see. We're now joined in three corners, and then two sides. We're going to join now in the side of this third sided join. Right in that big hole, we're going to work a slip stitch. Okay, and now we're ready to complete our last corner and join it to the corner join on these two motifs here. So we'll come back in our working yarn, our working motif, work three doubles. Chain one, slip stitch into that same center join of the two motifs adjacent, chain one, work three doubles again in our same chain three space on our working motif. And slip stitch to join in the top of the chain three at the beginning of the round. And fasten off. So now we've done, oh, isn't that great? We've done taken this simple motif and joined it on three sides, in all four of the corners actually, but done a three-sided join. And this is what you'll do for the last two motifs to create this gigantic, gorgeous cowl from joining motifs as we go. If you have any questions about this project, by all means, leave them for me in the comments.
And please subscribe to my channel for more videos.